What's going on, guys? We're back with another video. Happy 2022! Yeah. Welcome to Crypto Geeko. I'm Ricky, and thank God we're here for a new episode. Today we're gonna be talking about smart contracts. We're gonna show you how to deploy your code from local to the Arweave network in a breeze. Yes, that's right. Arweave supports smart contracts, and on this tutorial, you're gonna be learning how to deploy a smart Weave contract to the Permaweb. Arweave is by far our favorite cryptocurrency. As you may know, my brother and I have been in crypto for a long time. We started as traders, but we learned soon that you can do a lot much more with crypto. You can do HODL for sure, but how about just using your crypto, right? Let's talk about it. So what is Arweave? People are more familiar with Bitcoin, right? The first cryptocurrency, Bitcoin, came into existence in nearly 2009, released by Satoshi Nakamoto. Bitcoin is a payment network that offers a new kind of money called cryptocurrency. And Bitcoin works thanks to the invention of a new kind of decentralized network and data structure called blockchain. But hey, more than a decade has passed since then. Do we have something better now? Yes, hell yeah. Thousands of new blockchains have emerged since then, each one trying to solve a different problem. Ethereum, for example, its greatest innovation probably was the introduction of their smart contracting platform, allowing humans to have a decentralized work computer, a public Turing complete machine, where you pay some Ether in exchange of secure, decentralized and distributed computation. With blockchains running smart contracts, a new era for the internet began. Web 3.0. Current web has passed for two stages so far. The first stage was Web 1.0 at the 90s, when the World Wide Web was born. And maybe some people still remember how websites looked in the 90s. Very ugly, to be honest. But later, the web evolved to its next stage, Web 2.0. At the start of 2000, we saw the birth of more interactive and dynamic websites like blogs and the first social media sites like Facebook, Twitter and YouTube. And we are living on this stage right now. So maybe the question is, can the web evolve again? Yes, it can. A new big step is coming with Web 3.0. The promise of a decentralized web, a semantic web driven by modern technologies like AI and blockchain, seems to be around the corner. Not many people is aware of this, but you can start creating truly decentralized applications using current blockchain technology, and smart contracts are the core for these decentralized apps or DApps. And how these DApps look? They look the same as traditional web applications. Visually, they look the same as Web 2.0 sites. The biggest difference is the underlying infrastructure supporting the app. This means, for example, where is hosted the application, the content, and where is the database hosted. Usually, web developers host their applications on private and centralized services like GoDaddy, Amazon, Google Cloud, Microsoft Azure, among other examples. So let's see what Arweave is about. What is Arweave? Arweave is a protocol that allows you to store data permanently, sustainably, with a single upfront fee. The protocol matches people who have hard drive space to spare with those individuals and organizations that need to store data or host content permanently. This is similar to how Uber connects drivers with people who need transport. This is achieved in a decentralized network like Bitcoin, and all data stored is backed by a sustainable endowment, ensuring it is available in perpetuity. Arweave is like a blockchain for files, and we can see Arweave chain as an upgrade for the traditional internet. Thanks to Arweave, now we have a permanent and more transparent web called the Permaweb. The Permaweb looks just like the normal web, but all of its content, from images to full web apps, is permanent, retrieved quickly and decentralized, forever. Just as the first web connected people over vast distances, the permaweb connects people over extremely long periods of time. Our web has a lot of great features and even supports smart contracts, and today we're gonna see how easy and cheap it is to create and deploy a smart contract in our web. Alright, so let's jump in! For this demonstration, we're gonna use an online tool called Arcode Studio. From your favorite browser, open the next URL, arcode.studio. We are using Brave Browser, and well, Arcode Studio is an online code editor. Arcode was created for helping our web devs to create, debug, and deploy our web smart contracts without having to install anything on their computers. Arcode Studio is very easy to use, and if you are familiar with Visual Studio, then probably you will find some similarities. On the left side, we have the main toolbar. On the right side, we have the workspace. The first option in the toolbar is the File Explorer. Click on it to open or close the panel. Arcode has loaded by default some smart contract examples. Let's take a look at the LUT contract code. On the File Explorer, click on the LUT contract folder. You can create new files and folders in the workspace, but for now, let's take a look at the LUT contract example. You will see two files, a JS file with the contract code and a JSON file with the contract state. A LUT is a randomized adventurer gear generated and stored on-chain. If you want to learn more about how to create your own smart contracts, you can check the full LUT tutorial on the Redstone GitHub page, right here on this link. Smart contracts in our web are called smart web contracts. A smart contract is a piece of code. We use programming languages to create smart contracts. SmartWeb is a smart contracting platform built on top of the RWeb network. It allows users and developers to build programs whose execution is trustable and decentralized. One of the unique features of SmartWeb is the process of lazy evaluation, which removes the burden of processing smart contracts from the nodes and moves it to the users. This means that instead of running every piece of code on every machine in the network, like in Ethereum, for example, contract states are computed locally on the machines that request them. This has a number of effects. Smart contracts can be written in more accessible common programming languages, like JavaScript. Programs can execute with arbitrary amounts of compute without incurring additional network fees, among more benefits. How contracts work in SmartWeb? SmartWeb contracts work as follows. 1. When a developer publishes a contract, the program source code and its initial state are stored in our web transactions. This means that someone needs to publish the code and the state before the contract can be available. 2. When a user wishes to interact with a smart web contract, they write their inputs to the program in a new our web transaction. 3. Then, when a user wants to compute the current state of the contract, they query the network using GraphQL to find the contract's source code, initial state, and all user interaction transactions. 4. Once a list of the interacting transactions has been generated, the SmartWeb client then executes the inputs sequentially using the source code. Invalid transactions are simply ignored, and execution moves to the next interaction. In order to deploy our SmartWeb contract, we're gonna need to have these two files, one with the contract source code and the other one with the initial state. To deploy a contract, just click on the deploy button from the toolbar. The first time you click the deploy button, you will see a message saying that you need to log in first. Click the accounts menu and choose an option. Currently, our code supports rConnect, RWeb App Wallet, Fini Wallet, and Login by Key File. For this tutorial, I'm gonna use the RWeb App Wallet. I already have my wallet configured, but please remember that you need to configure your wallet first to start using any dApp, but because of time, we're not covered that part today. You will see your wallet info like address and balance on the accounts panel if the login succeeds. Once you log in, you can go back to the deploy panel and start the deployment process again. Deploying a smart contract using Arcode is extremely easy and flexible. you have two deployment methods to publish your contract. The first one is called contract source from file, and the second one is contract source from transaction. From the R-Code deploy panel, you can also define the network to which you want to connect. By default, R-Code provides a list of allowed networks, like localhost. Selecting this option will make R-Code to connect with your localhost on port 1984. This is the perfect option for private and local testing. If you want to run your own local instance of R-Local, this is your option. If you select RWIP or RWIP Dev Mainnet, you will deploy your contract to the RWIP Mainnet. If you're enjoying this video, please remember to subscribe and click the like button. And remember, you're gonna need R tokens to deploy your contracts or to create any real transaction on the RWIP chain. If you choose the RWIP mainnet as the network, please be sure of having enough R tokens. I'm running my own R local instance, so I'm gonna use the localhost option. R local is an RWIP gateway-like server. It's an amazing tool for testing purposes, and you can check it out on their official GitHub site, right here. github.com/textory/rlocal. Running an rlocal instance is great for testing our own contracts without the inconvenience of paying any real fee. Let's continue. If you choose the contract source from file method, you will have to select the contract state and source code from the workspace files. For this demonstration, I'm gonna select the loot contract files, but keep in mind that you can create your own files as well. And just click the deploy button when you are ready. And that's it. A few confirmation pop-ups will appear according to the selected login method. This is because all transactions need to be signed first by their creators. You will receive a confirmation message on the deploy panel with your transaction ID if your contract is deployed successfully. At this point, your transaction has been created but is not yet accepted by the network. Whether your transaction is accepted or not will depend on a few things, but mainly on the fact that whether or not you have enough R balance. You can check for the status of your transaction in R-Code. Copy the transaction ID generated on the deployment step and click the search option from the toolbar. Select your network, paste your transaction ID, and click the search button when you're ready. And finally, once your contract is deployed, you can start interacting with it from R-Code. To do it, click the Run and Debug button and fill the fields as needed. R-Code supports view state and dry run interactions for testing purposes, but also supports write state interactions. As you can see, R-Code is very easy to use. I hope that you have found this tutorial useful. Thanks for watching us. Please don't forget to subscribe. God bless you and see you next time.